Moody's expects the Philippines GDP to grow faster than most of its regional peers this 2020 following the approval of the country's spending budget. Moody says the Philippines' 4.1 trillion peso budget will help sustain the country's rapid economic growth against an uncertain global backdrop. For more on this, we now have on the line Christian De Guzman in Singapore. He's Senior Vice President of Moody's Investor Service, Sovereign Risk Group. Happy New Year, Christian. Welcome back to the program.
Happy New Year and good afternoon.
So just how significant is this just signed 2020 budget of the Philippines?
Well, I think it's significant given what we saw last year, which was the delay in the passing of the budget in 2019 led to some of the weaker outcomes in terms of real GDP growth for the Philippines, weaker than what we've seen in a couple of years. So in essence, the timely, albeit still a bit late, but you know, we are expecting full implementation of a 12-month implementation of the 2020 budget. This is key to helping to restore GDP growth to where it was prior to 2019.
And part of the support to growth will come from budget implementation. So how crucial is that implementation going to be? How closely will Moody's be watching?
Well, I think when you saw the progress that had been made by this administration in addressing the chronic underspending problem that we saw earlier this decade, it was actually quite notable. In 2018, we actually saw more money being spent than that was actually allocated for, meaning that there was a degree of effectiveness put in by the DBM in terms of that budget implementation. So going forward next year, this is quite an ambitious budget in terms of the size of the increase. And also, let's not forget that a lot of the some of the spending that was not allocated or was allocated for 2019, but was not spent in 2019, will carry over into 2020. So it is quite an ambitious ask on the part of the government to execute, but we do see this as a supporting factor for growth in general in 2020.
All right, but your assessment comes as an uncertain global backdrop looms. There's this heightened geopolitical risk that could potentially displace Filipino workers in Iraq and Iran, dealing a blow to remittances. And the Philippines is also a net oil importer. So how big are these risks, these external risks to economic growth?
These external risks are indeed material, but the Philippines is not alone in facing these risks. I would say that some of the more notable channels have been mentioned by the previous report, including remittances. But I would also note that that geopolitical risk is a key theme that we've been highlighting for all sovereigns globally and across the region. And indeed, the unpredictability of the events over the past week really attest to that. So it is a key risk factor, not just for the Philippines, but for everyone else.
So where does the Philippines stack up in the order of risk then, if everyone is going to be affected by geopolitical risk?
Well, I think one thing that we do need to understand is the different channels. So certainly remittances are a key part of that. The dependence on oil is also a key part of that. And certainly not just the supply of oil, but what's going to happen with higher oil prices. We're already in a situation where the Philippines reverted to a current account deficit a couple of years ago. So higher oil prices does threaten that widening of that current account deficit, especially in light of the very robust domestic demand that we're expecting.
So the approved 2020 budget is overall a credit positive, and the Philippines stands at Baa2 stable. So will Moody's be putting the current ratings under review?
Well, we do have an annual or a regular cycle, but I think I would also note that along with the spending that is implied by the package, we also wanted to highlight that there are other things going on in terms of the fiscal picture in the Philippines, which are as important, and that includes revenue reform. Indeed, we saw a few excise tax hikes that were previously scheduled to kick in at the beginning of the year as part of the first train package, and we also saw higher tobacco taxes that were part of the law that was passed last year. So there are important revenue reforms that are in train, which do help the underlying improvement in the fiscal situation, notwithstanding the larger spending that we expect to see over the next year or so.
So these important revenue reforms are going to be crucial on whether or not Moody's puts the Philippines for a possible review.
That's right. I think historically we have placed a great importance on the improvement in revenue, because this has been a weak point relative to other sovereign governments. There has historically been a low tax take in the Philippines as compared to similarly rated countries.
Final point, Christian, how fast will the economy grow in 2020 and 2021?
Well, we are expecting a rebound, a mild rebound in growth from our estimate of 5.8% in 2019 to 6.2% this year. And it may be too early to call with great precision on what's happening in 2021. But I think we can pencil in a continued degree of acceleration, perhaps to the middle of the 6 to 7% range, based on the continued implementation of the government's infrastructure program.
All right. Thank you so much for the assessment there, Christian De Guzman of Moody's in Singapore.